Stop moving. Everyone just freeze. Ready? Good afternoon, and thank you for joining us. I'm Chet Chesterton, and today I'm joined by Vietnam War veteran Richard Small. Richard, thank you so much for being here, and thank you for your bravery fighting in the only war America has ever lost. Your bravery is just truly astonishing.
Well, you're welcome, and it's an honor to be here. It's an even greater honor to fight for ungrateful citizens like yourself, so I'm very happy to be here, for sure.
Now, tell me why you wanted to fight in the war and help your country.
You know, Chet, I just really wanted to fight those Nazis, you know, when they broke out in Germany. I just had to do everything in my power to shut them down.
Now, Richard, I'm pretty sure that's World War II you're talking about. You know, the PTSD from the war might be getting to your head, you know, something like that.
Oh, yeah. Right, sorry. Of course, World War II. I just, you know, I lose it with age sometimes. I just was too filled with that, I was just filled with that American patriotism, you know? That's why I wanted to fight, really. Let me tell you a story.
One day, me and my crew, we were attacked by a bunch of the Vietnamese. All hope seemed lost, but then I came up with a genius solution. Thanks to my master plan, we got away with our lives. And that became known as the Battle of Gettysburg.
But wait, are you sure that's Vietnam? Because I'm pretty sure Gettysburg was the Civil War.
Really? Are you sure? Yeah. Were you out there? Were you fighting on the front lines? Were you fighting for our freedom? Yeah, I didn't think so.
It just... Now, Richard, I heard that you actually brought somebody today that could help us in this interview.
Yes, I brought my cousin, Poe. Poe fought with me, fought alongside me every step of the way through the war. We sweat together, bled together, and almost died together.
Now, I'd also like to thank you, Poe. Thank you for your bravery. It's truly astonishing.
Action.
Now, Poe... From what I've been told by your cousin Richard, I'm assuming that you fought at the front lines with him throughout the war, if I'm correct. Now, with all that information, what was your experience like in the battle that he mentioned previously?
I really wanted to fight the Nazis, the Japanese. The Chinese, the Russians, the Vietnamese. Oh yeah, I really wanted to fight the Vietnamese. Yeah, I actually got this injury, this bad boy, back in Nam.
So you're telling me. And I don't mean any disrespect. You're telling me you broke your leg in Vietnam over 40 years ago, and you're still wearing the cast?
Yeah. Never recovered, still have the bullet in there too.
Okay, whatever. Just now, what these veterans don't know is we've interviewed some of their family members previous to this occasion and asked them how it feels to have a veteran in their family. Let's take a listen.
Wait, what? No.
How does it feel to know your brother is a war veteran? Does it give you a sense of pride?
War veteran? He ain't no war veteran. Is that what he told you? His biggest accomplishment in life is putting the toothpaste back in the toothpaste bottle. Yeah, I know.
Do you get a sense of safety knowing your uncle fought in a war and came out alive?
Who, Uncle Poe? Dude, he's never fought in a war.
Him and his cousin go around telling people all the time they fought in a war because they look big and tough, but the fact is, he can't even hold a gun.
Yo, what's up, guys? My name is Eddie Gaming. Like, subscribe to my new videos. Pokemon Red 2 coming out soon. Maybe collab with
A7. Yo, what's Eddie Gaming? What's good, my dude? Hey, can I get a selfie?
Yeah, sure.
Hey! Dude, hang out with Crazy Uncle Rich.
I met him at a convention.
That's so sick. Alright, I'll catch you later.
But anyways, yeah, my friend Richard, yeah, he's saying he's a crazy Vietnam veteran, all that stuff. But anyways, I'm just really concerned about him.
How do you explain this?
They're lying. They're crazy. Tell him, Poe. See, he's having a flashback right now.
Now, I'm gonna try and be civil about this. Tell me one battle. One battle. In the Vietnam War. One battle.
Gettysburg?
No.
Cinco de Mayo?
No.
Alamo?
No.
Desert Storm?
No.
Waterloo?
That wasn't even in the United States! Look me in the eye and tell me you fought in Vietnam.
What's going on?
Hey, what's going on here? What's going on? Put that back on, you need it! We need that for- Hey! Chase after him!
Dummy cell beam mass ivory. Karma has served the price in her hand bad. Shooting me with no advisory. He was pitching dummy cell beam mass ivory.
Rick, let the car! Go, 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 go!
Go, 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 go